Yes, ma'am.
Who's presenting the meeting? Can you share your screen?
Vedant, are you sharing?
Vedant, you can't hear me.
Vedant,
hello.
You may be mute.
Yes, hello, I can hear you.
Yes,
I'm unmuted now.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, Vedant. Share your presentation. All others, keep your camera on throughout the presentation till the Viva is over. Yes, Vedant. You have the time given is you have 10 minutes, 5 minutes for your PPT, 7 minutes to show your output, and finally after that the live question and answer session. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, let's start the presentation.
Yes, we can start.
Yes,
yes. Your voice is slow.
Slow hai? Zyada karo.
Yes, volume is low.
Remove your earphones and then speak, please.
Now is it okay? Yes, 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 Yes
and topic modeling, text pre-processing, exploratory data analysis, insights and feature extractions. So I will be highlighting the what are the main important blocks. So the very first is the text pre-processing, where the data is being fetched from the source and it is being cleaned. Now cleaning means removing the insufficient, irrelevant data that is not of our use. The second is exploratory data analysis. Now here comes the main important part. The counter vectorizers, the TFD vectorizers, then word embedding and the plotting the word cloud. Now what it means? Cloud vectorizers means whenever we are dating the we're fetching the data, it has to be the form the machine can understand. So we are making the metrics in which we are giving the review of positive and negative to each and every word in the form of ones and zeros. And the matrix is formed, and that matrix is fed as an input to the data model, where the words are processed in such a way that we can make the analysis. And for analysis, there are two different things: topic modeling and the feature extraction. Topic modeling is nothing but we are grouping the similar elements. Like if I say about the crypto, suppose an example, then trading, then opto FX, then money, extent, all these terms are related to similar group of words. And the feature extractions is nothing but giving again a positive or a negative emotion, like annoying or poor. These words lead to the negative emotion, while fabulous, fantastic, happy, this leads to the positive emotion. So the groups are the words are being grouped in such category. With the next slide. So this is a pre-processed text when the text is in raw format. Next slide. Start the demo. Working.
Later, after everyone presentation, we will do the demo.
Then move to the next slide. So these are the three blocks where our model is used: the count, TFD, and the co-occurrence. Count is nothing but the whole text, the whole paragraph. it is fed into the input and the number of the words. Suppose the sentence is I don't like something, then the different words are tokenized and it is divided into the small chunks of the part. In TF-IDF, what it does is, it again, as I told you, it divides into the group, it gives the reviews to each and every word, and it forms in a matrix form. And the co-occurrence is nothing but in a matrix there is one column which will give the frequency or the co-occurrence of the word which is repeated every time. The more it is repeated, the more it is relevant to our context. Tarang will be continuing the next slide. Over to you, Tarang.
Yes, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, you are audible, Tarang.
So, as my friend Hitesh explained earlier, how relevant is a word in a complete document, here is the formula. X1 is equals to TF into IDF. TF means term frequency and IDF means inverse document frequency. Term frequency is how much times the word is repeated in the document, and inverse document frequency, it means how rare the word is in the complete process.
Keep your video on, Tarak.
Ma'am, actually I'm attending on the PC and I don't have webcam. If I can attend from the mobile, then I can keep
so
the video.
People are knowing that this is exam.
Okay. Ma'am, can I continue now?
Yes, you continue. But you should have that seriousness.
Okay, ma'am, sorry. With our next slide. So here we can see there are two graphs. One is the frequency in a single document, that is important. If the word is frequently used, and the other graph is frequently in the entire corpus. The graph is declining, that means it is not very important. With our next slide. Here the importance of TF and IDF is given. One of the major advantages is that frequency and relevance is captured with respect to a particular word, and from that word we can plot the word cloud and the frequency allocation, the graph. And the one big drawback is the context is still not captured. With our next slide. So here in the picture we can see the table is given and different kinds of words, Adi, Asra, Mava, Asika and all that in the table above. Abandon. This abandon are the different kinds of words that are used in this different kinds of parvas. Adi parva, ashrama, vasika. The number of times the words are repeated, here it is repeated. 25. Well, next slide. So here is the short summary of what we have done till now. Retrieve text, pre-process text and extract the sentences. Download and parse the text, tokenizing and removing the stop words and ranking the words and sentences. And the next slides will be explained by my friend Vedan.
So, so far we have not looked at the relation between two words. We are just looking at the occurrence and the frequency each one occurs in. So in the left table you can see arranged ascending order. How many unique words, what is the vocabulary of each parva, how many unique words are used in that parva. So Anushasana parva uses most unique words, Karna parva is uses the least unique words. So this may be a function of how many actual words are there. Actually, it is a function of how many actual words are there, except for Adi Parva. Although it is large, it uses less amount of unique words. So, another interesting fact we can do here without even understanding the relation between a sentence, without even analyzing a sentence, is that people are referring to each other. How many times they are referring to each other? Not by their name, but the whole title, so and so, king of so and so. Relative of so and so. So and these are just that is about kinship, and these are just means your honor, such means, for example, your majesty, such words, how many times are they occurring in each parva. So actually, although Karna parva is the shortest parva and has the least unique words, we can see why does such kinships occur here. Because Karna is a king, maybe that's why Drona and Bhishma were not king, maybe that's why. These are some things which we can understand without analyzing the sentences yet. Next approach is analyzing. This was the bag of words approach. We take all the vocabulary, about 60,000 unique words, put them in a bag as if to say, and pick out random words and count how many times they are occurring. Now we want to see the relationship between to any two words in the text or two consecutive words. After one word, how many times the next word is coming. So for that we cannot use this bag of words model because it disregards the order but maintains the frequency. So here we can see we are using the latent Dirichlet allocation algorithm to group our text into topics. Four topics we were able to extract reliably which have less overlap, and here at the bottom you can see there are warfare, kin affinity, the original narration. So there is a story, means narration going on inside another narration. So if at Janamejaya's snake sacrifice, someone is asking him to narrate some part of the Mahabharata, and in Yudhishthir's Rajasuya's sacrifice, another narration is going on. So these three layers of narration is another topic in itself, and then spirituality or religiosity we can say is the fourth topic we were able to extract. This we did using GenSim. Now coming back to our bag of word models, we will see the examples that are not bag of word models. These two we saw before. Hitesh showed the count factorizer, TF-IDF was shown by Tarang, and one hot encoding means taking a word, if it occurs in a sentence or text, give it a 1, if it doesn't, 0. So either 1 or 0, no multiplicity, no number of times the word comes, nothing like that. So using that technique, one-hot encoding, we were able to plot these word clouds. So after removing words which don't give us much meaning, we were able to understand that the Adi Parva is like the foretelling what is going to happen in the rest of the text. So the future tense is present much more. So in the Sabha Parva, again we see the coronation of Yudhishthir is there. So he has more importance. Dhritarashtra splits the kingdom into two parts. So he is the second most discussed person. Now another thing is in the actual war narrative, the next Senapati or the next commander-in-chief, he gets the most discussed. So in the Drona Parva, the next Senapati, this is the Karna Parva, but Karna is more discussed in the Drona Parva because he is the likely candidate. After things look grim, Drona does not recover. This was another insight we were able to garner. And this is the demo we'll see by clicking this link. We know before that you can complete.
Yes, ma'am, can I am audible?
Yes.
But your video is not on, we know.
Yes, ma'am, can I put my video on?
Yeah, you have to put your video on.
Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, I am visible, no?
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. So basically, in this slide, this is the slide containing all the 18 Mahabharata Parvas, and basically the 18 Parvas are here. We have shown the sentiment analysis of the Adi Parvas, then Virata Parva and the Vana Parva. So all the
what is the plot called as? These are representing 18. That is okay. What is that plot?
Yes, this is a frequency graphs of all the parvas.
So basically, you tell. And what is it representing?
Yes, it is representing the incidences and all the emotions that have occurred and happened in the all the 18 parvas. So these incidences have occurred. So I will first of all explain the three main important and the first three parvas, starting from three, that is Adi Parva, Virata Parva and Drona Vana Parva. So for the Adi Parvat, these are the frequencies here we have shown in the graph. Inclination occurs when some incident occurs, and declination happens when the situations are settled down or calmed down. And in the first calm down in the first diagram, so the Adi Parva, it is described how the Mahabharata come to be and narrated by some assembly rishis. Yes, ma'am.
Y-axis, what does it represent in the graph?
Yes, the y-axis, these are the numbers of all the incidents occurs. The
so
ratios
that,
of...
then what is x-axis? Because here you are
yes,
saying 0.002.
Here are 0, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 are all the number pages on which the parvas have been put, and the 0.0 and 0.2 have the incidences, the highest and the lowest number of incidences that have been occurred in the different parvas shown here.
Incidences?
What, ma'am?
It is not so clear, Vinod. Somebody else can give the explanation of what is y-axis and x-axis. X-axis you have told, but y-axis that is not the proper, it is not giving so much clarity. Number of incidences in each parva, number of incidences will come. You are not here analyzing number of incidences. Your task is different. What are you analyzing?
Ma'am, we are analyzing the frequencies of
logarithmic value.
I am not telling about whether it is logarithmic or whether it is put without logarithm. What is it representing? First you should tell that now.
On the x-axis, we have the progression of the parva from 0 to 100%. On the y-axis, we have the polarity. The range is minus 1 is highly negative to plus 1. But we can see not always it comes down below 0. Because Adi Parva is very jovial, means hope is there always. So that's why. But all other parvas, yeah, even Bhishma Parva comes down. So when someone is expressing victory over killing their opponent, how they express their victory, that is actually boosting it in the positive direction, not the actual death itself.
Okay. Emotion. Actually, that's what expected. I expected that answer from all the three of you. Emotion is there in the y-axis, in the form of polar, you know. So it is not the frequency. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, the further Vedanta get the make the first leg. Yes, so total here 18 parvas, the plottings of 18 parvas we have showed, so that we finally conclude the highest inclinations and emotions that have been covered. The total 18 parva, in the 18 parvas, the Sabha parva and the Maha Mahaprasthanika are the highest, Savaparva Mahaprasthanika and the Sandhya Parva are the highest incident occurring parvas, and the lowest parvas are Anushasana Parva, Mula Musa.